Greetings everyone and welcome back to Stardew Valley and of course to Fuzzy Fairy Farm where we have some crab pots. Oh, I'm very happy about that. Alright, let's check on the fortune teller for this morning. It is going to be a neutral day. That's not actually that bad. Now, for the weather, beautiful sunny day tomorrow. Fantastic. Now that means we're going to be able to get some fishing done, I fancy. First and foremost though, all of this into not very much fertilizer. Oh well. I really need another scarecrow, I would say. Let me see. I've not got enough of this. I've got some of that. What do I need for a scarecrow? Is it coal? Yes, it is coal. Okay, well, let me go and chop down some trees. Probably going to be doing a little bit of work on the farm as the main thing today. We can take this now. I can put it somewhere else and this can come down. That might give us enough wood, actually. I've got a lot of stuff to do. I am avoiding cutting all of the grass at the moment because I do not have anywhere to put it, and so I would be wasting the potential gains for my silo. So I don't want to cut it down just yet. We've got until fall until I need to start cutting it down, so hopefully we should be okay. Right, that should be enough for me to make a scarecrow. It is a good day today, I think. Now, I've actually been thinking, I know, dangerous, I'm not gonna have double paths. I've decided against it, so I'm gonna cut this back since I'm walking over here anyway. I'm not gonna go to the greater effort of doing it for everywhere else, but for here, pom, let's put this there. There we go. Then actually, no, let me move this somewhere else. Hello, Leafin, how you doing? Hopefully well. Let's pop that there instead. That should cover pretty much everything I needed to cover. Right, let's drop these off for now. I've got more of that I should turn into more fertilizer. There we are. Drop that off as well. You got a tree tap? No, you do not. Let me fix that. Now, I'm fairly certain I've already delivered the maple syrup, so I don't need to deliver any more of it. Let's pop that in there. Let's get the actual fertilizer back out because, of course, there are two things that I want to plant. I want to plant you and I want to plant you. Where do I want to plant you? Well, that is the question, isn't it? I've got 4, 5, 6. Ah, oh, damn it. This is a terrible place to plant anything, I'm noticing. I'm not approving of this area with its lacking of places for me to plant stuff, I must confess. Right, we want the corn because that's one of the crops that we can get gold star on. No, I'm not going to put it over there, damn it. I'll place it down here. This is... Oh, damn. This is really, really painfully bad to look at. Don't think that I don't notice, okay? I do. And it does hurt me as much as it hurts you. I promise you're not suffering alone. But you are going to have to suffer for a little while longer because I've got so many things I need to do. I can't spend all my time worrying about this. Let's see if I can water all three from this spot, because if I can, that's going to make so many things more easy. Oh, I can! How glorious is that? Sure, we'll do that one. And then both of these. Don't worry, Leafin. Okay, worry, Leafin, you made me water in the wrong place. It's okay, I forgive you. Let's pop some there. Now, I've been told that perhaps it would actually be better for me if I check... Why? No. This way. Ow! Stop! Stop your shenanigans! Ah, you scallywag you. Nope. It's not gonna work. Okay, fine. I've learned my lesson. You win, game. I'll... You know what? Let's do it from this direction. So much easier. And yes, I know I'm wasting time. Damn it. The game is making me waste time. Don't blame me. Blame the game. But someone has mentioned that I should probably check on the bat at night. And that does make a bit of sense. Oh, Leafin's wagging his tail. That's lovely. I thought for a moment I was about to be attacked by a bat. But no, it was Leafin being happy. I am happy too, Leafin. I am happy that you are happy. And I think that is the end of the water for my watering can. There we go. Now we can get all of you done. Should be good. But as I was saying, might be a case that I need to check the bat's cave at night time. Oh my lord, really? I'm that low on energy already? accept. I will drop this off along with you. But I clearly... Yeah, I'm going to make some food. I could always go... You know what? I'm going to make this food anyway. But I could go to the bathhouse. But I'm... No. No. We're going to go to the bathhouse. The reason for that is that later on, I might want to go to the mine. And it's better for me to just have food to go to the mine with. So this is fine. We'll pop to the bathhouse and then we'll come back. There we go. Trying to be efficient. Actually, do I need the pine tar artisan bundle? No. Ammo bundle for crops. Not going to be there, but it might be. It's not going to be here. Oh, yes, it is. Pine tar. Fantastic. We're almost at the exotic forage bundle. I imagine we won't be far off that because I planted all of those, well, a good deal of the tree taps at the same time. So they should all return, should all generate sap at around about the same speed. So hopefully. I also need to go visit the merchant today. Yeah. I'm going to be looking for a good deal. Quite a lot of the best things the merchant has cost 1,000. Which is a bit rough, but... let us just rest for a moment. Steamy hot baths. I'm going to take a sip of tea. I don't recommend taking tea into the steamy hot baths unless they're your steamy hot baths. And you're at least as proficient at not spilling your tea as I am. There we go. Almost full energy bar. Now, I should get those crab pots in the water as well by the end of the night would be wise. There we go. And it's only 1:40. You know what? I'm actually going to swing by Pierre. Well, no. I'm going to go to the merchant first. I'll check on Pierre's... Maybe... Yeah, we'll check on Pierre's on Monday. Because I haven't got that much money right now. There's also a couple of things I want to do in terms of just trying to fish. I believe I may have a chance of getting a sturgeon up here. It's going to be a sunny day tomorrow, though. I'm changing my mind. Actually, I'm going to go and say hello tomorrow. I'm fairly certain you've got a best chance of finding the sturgeon up here in the mountain lake, but only on sunny days. Please don't destroy my tent. I would never do such a thing. Why would you say it? You hurt my soul every time you do. I worked at the clinic yesterday. We didn't have a single patient. Well, that's good. I guess people get sick less during the summer. I don't know. Have you seen Sam? It looks like his face is exploding. Maybe that's just in the spring. Either way. Let's go and get our watering down. We'll go straight down to the merchant, I think. Probably wise to get that out of the way, because I can just come back up and finish off my work in the farm. But today is definitely going to be a farm work day. I need really badly to get myself a upgraded axe. I want to clear out these stumps. Now, I'm not sure if I can get into the Forgotten Forest with a regular copper axe. I seem to recall that I did last time. But I know that the normal fallen trees require an iron axe. I don't know if you're just given a little bit more of a break because it's a special area you need to get to. I don't know. Some spangled slime, red plate, fish stew, blue jazz, void mayonnaise, cave carrot, sandfish, puffer fish, cave carrot. Are any of those fish ones that I need? Let's just have a quick look. Speciality fish. No, I've got both of them. Okay, so we're fine there. Blue jazz. Is that one that I need? Where would that be? It might even be the bulletin board. Let me double check. No, need a poppy for that. Need a sunflower there. Also need the red cabbage. New. I doubt very much it'll be here, because this is more crops. Craft room, though. Oh, no, I don't think so. No, we don't need anything from the merchant today. Sorry, merchant, no sale today. Thank you very much for dropping by, though. I do appreciate your visiting every week. Twice, in fact. Very, very good merchant there. Actually, I'm going to chop down this tree. Grab us a little bit more sap. There we go. Now, the thing I want to get from Pierre is, I'm not sure if he sells red cabbage in the first year or not. If he does, I need to pick it up. If he does not, then I definitely want more melons to increase the likelihood of us getting the 5 gold star melons. Otherwise, we could be at risk of losing out on that one. I mean, ultimately, now that I've planted corn, there's a good chance that we're going to get 5 gold star corn, and then I just need 5 gold star pumpkins. But if I could get all of that done, all of the quality forage done, crops done in summer, that just means I'm free with my my autumn crops to just do pretty much what I want. There we go. I would still need one of every crop just for the autumn crops bundle, but the quality crops would be fine. I wouldn't have to worry too much about getting a specific amount of gold star of anything. And that is something I really would not mind. I do believe it was the gold star crops that held me up last time I played through the game. There we go. We'll get these ones as well. And finally this one. I don't know why I said finally, because I've still got a bunch more to do. But we're almost done. I can... Well, I can't go to Pierre's now, unfortunately, which is a bit of a shame, but oh well. Damn you. What I would like to do is maybe go fishing. Sure, we could go fishing up on the at the lake. But at 6:20 p.m, it's going to start becoming night fishing time shortly, so perhaps I won't. Perhaps I won't do that. Perhaps instead I will simply get these in the water. Bump, bump, bump. Bait them as well. There we are. Got so much bait. So good. Right, okay. Well, in that case, let us have a look. What do I need to make more tree taps? And how many trees do I need to tap? I've got 1, 2, 3 that I need taps on. And are you okay otherwise? No, you've got grass growing up around you, and I don't like that. Let's get rid of those. Are you okay? You've got no young sproutlings messing with you at all? No. So we just need 3 more tree taps. And that's going to require 6 more copper, which I've got. Thing is, I would like to upgrade the axe. I just mentioned that. I can risk it, I think, just to get these done. I think we're okay for that. I want to take out the wood. Had my fingers not on the home keys. Never a good sign. I also want to make all of this into fertilizer. I'm going to have to chop down another tree as well. Drop those off. There we go. I need to get that to Gunther at some point. Right. Okay. You. And you. And unfortunately, I just spotted you there. There we are. Really? There's another one right there? My lord. I can barely see it. I just need 40 wood. And then we've got all of the currently adult trees tapped, which is a pretty good place to be. I wonder if slimes could sneak up on me in the long grasses. I would not be too surprised if they could. And that would be horrific. Those cunning swines. There we are. That was actually quite a lot of wood from one tree. And we'll take this one out next. But yeah, the axe is definitely the next upgrade that I need. I'm doing okay for progressing in levels in the mine currently with my basic pick. Yes, having a better pick would make it so much easier. And we are going to need one before we get down to the lower levels. But certainly by level 60, I'm going to want the better pick. Otherwise, I'll be using so much energy just to get through the rocks. I'll never make it 5 levels. However, right now, getting the fiddlehead fern is super important for me. And that is going to require that I can get into the secret forest, I think, in this season. So a race to 2,000 so I can upgrade my axe to copper, and hopefully, that's all I'm going to need. There's no great I've not got amazing amounts of confidence that that is all I'm going to need, but we'll see. There we go. And so this last one is tapped. Fantastic. Oh, I got a little seed. Excellent. I shall have to keep a watch on my trees there, make sure that they actually don't have any seeds on them, because if they do, then that's something I'm going to want to use. Like, you can just be eaten. I'll take those with me. In fact, we can sell those. We can sell these too. Keep the dandelion. Stop that up. Need to try and condense what's in my chests at the moment. Put that in there. Everything else I basically want on me right now. Trash I'm keeping hold of, because eventually I'm going to be able to turn that into something. So I want to wait on that one. I did water my coffee plant, didn't I? Let me just double check. There's no reason not to. And of course, haha! Yes, I know. I did. I'm wondering how many people have currently made comments that I've forgotten that. It's just one of those little things. All this time, you see me regularly derp. You see it all the time, in fact. But just as often as it happens, well, maybe not quite as often, that's a little bit generous for me, but quite often, I notice it before the end of the episode. And so this is basically just a test. Who comments before watching the whole video? I know quite a few people do. And I strongly suspect a number of them will have been bleeding from the eyes at the thought of me forgetting to water my ancient seed. Hello, I have some pine tar. I think that was down here. No, it was the artisan bundle, actually, I think. Let me just double check. Artisan bundle? No, it was not. No, it'll be forage down here then. I actually feel that we're making some really good progress at the moment. Really, really good progress. All we need now is oak resin. Or any number of mushrooms. Any kind of... Except for the Chantal and the common mushroom. The red, purple, or the morel mushroom will complete that for us. We are honestly making much better progress with these than I figured we would at this point. I'm not going to chop that tree down because I know Caroline hangs out there. And for those who are wondering, those are flowers on the bushes. They're not actually berries. They have a very distinctive look when they're berries. So that's why I've not been checking them. There's quite a few people who have been very concerned that I've been missing the opportunity to get grapes, I think. But no, we're fine with that. Well, actually, I thought that was a daffodil there hidden behind. No, it's just regular flowers. Okay. Well, let's head back then. Fairly boring day, all things said and done. I've got a little bit of energy, though. You know what? Sure. I'll have a quick cast into my pond, probably fish out a can of Joja Cola, and then I'll be very upset. But I may as well. Assuming it doesn't get to 1 o'clock before I get a bite. Which it might do. There we go. Ooh, it's actually a fish, too. Now this is a turn up for the books. What am I going to catch in my own little lake? What kind of fish has been stocked in my lake? A chub. Okay. Well, since I've still got a little bit of time. At 1 o'clock, I'll leave, but I'll do a little bit of fishing here. So I may as well. Easy money. And green algae. Okay. Well, that's good enough. Let's go and drop this off. I'm going to need to go... In fact, actually, I'm just going to eat this. Because I'll get virtually nothing for it anyway. But I'm going to need to go and visit the bathhouse tomorrow in order to have any energy to do anything. I'll start the day with half energy. I won't even be able to water all my plants with that. Ooh, there we are. Fishing rod proficiency, new craft recipe, the spinner and the trap bobber. Ah, oh, wonderful. At this point, it becomes very a realistic goal to try and get the legendary fish of the seasons. It'll still be a very rough fight for me at my current fishing level, but I could do it now with the trap bobber. To be honest, I could probably do it with some of the other bobbers as well, but it would be a very difficult fight. We're talking like, you know, those epic 30-minute battles against bosses in Final Fantasy VII kind of fight. Alright, who I see a glimmer within my scrying orb, a shard of knowledge from the future. The spirits are mildly perturbed today. Luck will not be on your side. How rubbish. What about the weather report? It's going to be a beautiful sunny day tomorrow. No, well, that's not as bad then. There we go. Hooray! We've got some of the stuff we need. Bomp, bomp, bomp. I'm fairly certain if we go and have a look at the fish tank. Actually, we've already got that, I think. Yeah, we got everything we needed for the fish tank. I don't need them at all now. This is purely just for my own pocket, I guess. Or is there something in the bundle over here? Enchanter's bundle, probably not. Field research. Oh, yeah, no, I've already given you the chub. No, I can just sell this. Well, that's brilliant, actually. Sure, I'll go ahead and start loading this up. Regularly visiting the cave will keep us with plenty of bait for those. So that's awesome. Right, well, I don't think there's really anything particular going on today, so I'm going to bring along my food. Going to make some more food. I've actually got a full energy bar, really? Wow, I'm surprised by that, frankly. I'm actually deeply surprised by that. Okay, well, in that case, I'm going to water everything then to start the day off with. And then we will probably do a little bit of fishing today and also head down the mines. That's what I'm thinking for today's chores. We don't have too much that we need to do or prepare for, really. And if we can get down another couple of levels in the mine, I would be a lot happy. We're going to start seeing iron around the levels that we're at now. So if we can get up to an iron axe, I absolutely know we'll have access to that forest. Then we'll be able to start getting the mushrooms. It'll all be good. Actually, what is it that I need for the greenhouse specifically? The animal bundle. I need to get some animals, basically. That's going to be a merchant thing until I can get a little bit further on. I need an eggplant, a pumpkin, and corn. I'll probably get that fairly soon. These will all come in time. Hopefully we'll get that and this season. So, yeah, we don't need the fiddlehead fern. I need to make some jelly, so I need to put some fruit in there. I also need to check with my bats. But honestly, if the bats can give me all of the types of fruit, then we're done. If I get all of the types of fruit soon, then we're done. Also, the honey would be fairly easy to get as well. So the animal bundle is probably the most difficult for me. Because to get large eggs of any variety takes time. We need to have a fair old bit of time with the animals to get them up to that. Wool, again, that's going to be a hard one. Ducks, not too bad. To get duck egg is not too bad. But to get a large goat milk, that is rough. Honestly, because that means you're going to need to have a goat and you're going to need to get their hearts level with you up quite a lot. The large milk and the large egg, not too hard because they're the first animals that you'll get at those in those particular buildings. I can't remember if I watered these. Well, drat. And yes, I am absolutely going to waste my energy doing it again, even if I have. Because ultimately, what do I lose by doing it? You know, I lose, you know, 4 bars of energy worth, well, not 4 bars, but 4 uses of my watering cans worth of energy versus an extra day on 12 of my crops. It's not that bad of a deal, really. Let's see, all of the just random odds and sods, mixed stuff. There we go. Don't worry, Leafin, I will water your dog's bowl when I get up there. Ah, no. Every time. I do it wrong every time in some way or another. It's one of those days, really. I know, Leafin. It is really bad. You have every right to be mocking me right now. There we go. Now, I am feeling a little bit like I haven't spent any time with the villagers. I miss my friends. The last 2 days have just basically been a shut-in doing work. I mean, yes, I've got a good work ethic, but my socializing could use some improvements, I feel. Ah, Leafin, that's right. Come over here. Allow me to be lazy. No, Leafin! Ah, you made me run anyway. Oh, well. I needed the exercise, possibly. Hello? Oh. I need to check you at night. I've been told that the forage just lingers. It doesn't ever disappear. So once they start producing, that's it. They start producing. Someone also said that happens every single night. Really? Because that seems OP. Like, it genuinely seems a little bit on the OP side. It shouldn't be that frequent, in my humble opinion. Certainly because mushrooms aren't that frequent. Have I got everything I need? Don't need my axe, really. Let's drop that off. Axe, you can go in here. Everything else, though, you can come with, I think. Yeah, more or less everything else can come with me. I want more melons. Those are the crops that I require. Oh, grape. And sweet pea. Yoink. Now, I don't typically make a lot of the wild forage bags in the other seasons other than winter. In winter, it makes a lot of sense because it's the only thing you can grow on your farm. But in the other seasons, it's not really that big of a deal. It's not much about anything, really. I'm going to pop in and see Harvey. Hello? Harvey? Oh, the doctor is not in. That is a shame. No one is in. What if someone was sick? Hello, it's Farmer Aavak. It is. You can just call me Aavak, though. I went to the beach last night after dark. Sometimes you can see strange lights bobbing over the sea. That actually sounds remarkably romantic. Or maybe that was just a dream I had. It doesn't feel real anymore. I wonder what you mean by that. Sure, would you like a sweet pea? Hey, how do you know I was hungry? This looks delicious. I know it's called the sweet pea, but it is a flower. I'm not sure you can eat sweet peas. Summer is a good time to eat a refreshing salad. Actually, I'm fairly... I'm not sure now. See, some things are named delicious things, and then other things are named really, really bad, but you can eat them. Or they're related to something horribly poisonous, but you can definitely eat them. It's confusing. It also doesn't help that a lot of the names of flowers I learned in Welsh, and they're different in Welsh. Let's see then. I can't see cabbage new. Poppy seeds? I'll grab a poppy. Another one. Yeah. I might even get some spangle seeds. I think Jazz likes spangle seeds. Yeah, I'll grab one of those too. Now, I could get a 5 melon seeds. That is not going to hurt my bank too much. And it allows me to continue trying to just plant more and more to get more and more chances at getting the right type. It's fairly early. You know what? I might spend the day just fishing today. Because there's not much that I need to do tomorrow either, all things said and done. I've got my food on me. If I decide to go into the mine, I can. But right now, I don't really need to. Right, I've got a prehistoric bone. I think I'm going to put it over here. With the Nautilus shells. There we are. Then, I am going to go and read these books. Now that we've got 3 to read. Mystery of the Dwarves. The dwarves call themselves Smalunanu, which translates to sky people. An odd name for a group that lives deep underground, isn't it? Another mystery of the dwarves is the advanced technology they supposedly possess. Evidence such as this had led me, despite the ridicule of my colleagues, to propose a new theory. I believe the dwarves are the remnants of a once advanced civilization whose interplanetary vehicle crashed on this planet long ago. I propose that this dwarvish spaceship bore down deep underground, and over time the dwarves became adapted to their new underground environment. My colleagues ask, why didn't they come above ground and live on the surface? Perhaps their old planet had a thicker atmosphere that protected them from stellar radiation, and they simply could not survive in our sunlight. That would explain why they only surface at night to take what they need from our houses. M. Jasper. I like M. Jasper's theory. Highlights from the Book of Yoba. Before time, there was only the endless golden light. The light called out to itself, Yoba. Yoba wanted more. Yoba swirled the golden light into a vortex. Yoba swirled and swirled until a hole formed in the eye of the vortex. From this hole sprang a seed. Yoba smoothed the golden light. Yoba smoothed and smoothed, and the light became soil. Into this soil, Yoba planted the seed. The seed sprouted, and behold! A vine sprung skyward, twisting and probing, casting a writhing shadow onto the golden void. After 11 days, the vine bore fruit. Yoba, with knowing wisdom, peeled the tough skin off the fruit and saw that the world was inside. And so that is how the world came to be. What a wonderful creation myth. Marriage guide for farmers. Specifically for farmers, this isn't true for anyone else. Before you ask someone to marry you, you'll have to date them for a while first. Ask someone to date you with a bouquet from Pierre's. Specifically Pierre's. When you're ready to pop the big question, you'll need to give them a mermaid pendant. Everyone knows what it means when you present them with one of those. It's rumored that the stormy days, the ghost of an old mariner appears in Stardew Valley, clutching just such a pendant. After the wedding ceremony, your partner will move in with you. Remember to treat your spouse well. They still like gifts, even after marriage. Paid for by Pierre. Ah, Pierre. Pierre. You're a bit of a scallywag. Right, let's go. And, oh, hello. I'm here to collect Clint's business tax. Oh, sorry, dude. Sometimes I wonder how I ended up in this town. Bloody mayor. There's a stack of metalworking blueprints. Right, I would like to process geos, please. And we've got jagite. I was going to say it was sulfur. Some stones. Some, I don't know. Limestone. Oh, that reminds me of my RimWorld playthrough. Everything is made of limestone. Ooh. Got a nicotite. Nicoite, rather. Not nicotite. Okay, thank you very much, Clint. Take care, bye. Right. I may have some new things for you, Gunther. I believe, in fact, I do. Nicoite, you can have this. Thank you. Okay, so we've got a couple of things we can plant, and we'll plant those in a little bit. Hey there. I smell a barbecue. Really? I hope your ice cream stall is not on fire. That's an odd smell to have around an ice cream stall. A very odd smell. One might assume that there is something horribly, horribly wrong if you can smell a barbecue where you're selling ice cream. Farming sounds so boring. What do you even do all day? Snoop around in your room. Dig for treasure. I care for the plants, mostly. And my animals. Sounds like a lot of work. It is. I'll be honest with you, it is. I end up knackered by about 12 p.m. every day. It is honest work, though. My soul feels refreshed. And then I might go to the bathhouse, or I might go to the pier and do some fishing, which is what I'm going to do today. I might then go to the mountain lake. Mm-hmm. Later on, I will go back to my farm and I will plant more seeds. I should have told her I care for, sunflowers all day. That would have impressed her. Oh, I was a bit late there. Come on then, you. Wah! We've got a legendary. That's way, way too early. There is no way I'm catching a legendary fish without a bobber. And with this rod. That was unfortunate. In fact, I'm not even going to fish by here. This area is protected by a legendary fish. We will go elsewhere. It is protecting its flock. I accept this. Well played, legendary fish. You taught me what for. Now, I wonder if this counts as a river fish. I wonder if all of the water on the ocean, on the beach, is considered ocean. Or if some of it is considered river. Which are we going to get? We're going to get the treasure chest. Excellent. That would have been a potential perfect. Ooh, a red mullet. Thank you. But I would really like those at tuna. I think I might need to be on one of the piers, though, for that. I think the only things that we really need right now is a tuna and a sturgeon. Those are the only summer fish. That is the only fish that I can only get in summer. And right now, I'm just aiming to try and get all of the ones that I can't get in any other way. Not sure if tuna is a rain fish, though. I don't think it is. I think it's just an ocean fish. So I'm going to stand out on the pier, far from where that bloody legendary fish was. The legendary fish comes over here and messes with me. Well, I guess there's not much I can do. It's like, well played, legendary fish. You may have my bait. Oh, there we go. Ah, that was almost a perfect. Damn me. Another red mullet. You know what? I'm going to sacrifice one of these red mullets to the spirit of the ocean in hopes that it will take pity on me and give me a tuna. If this is a tuna now, that is it. I'm going to like be sacrificing fish everywhere. It'll be the way it goes. I think that's a red mullet, though. Yep, another red mullet. It's fine. Oop. Ah! Okay, this one's moving differently. This has the potential to be something else. What are you going to be, fish? Tuna! Ha-ha! It worked! I've appeased the ocean spirits. Thank you very much, ocean spirits. I will give you another golden red mullet. I appreciate your patronage. This will be going to the community center. I believe the ocean spirits are probably on good terms with the Junimo. And the Junimo will probably let them know that, yeah, you know, Dan Aavak, he's a good guy. The local fishing scene got a little bit more lively. I might expand the ship's stock. The ship's stock, even. The ship's stock, which I sell in the shop. I wish that was the case. Don't mind that old dog next to the house. He might look at you cross, but he'll never get up from that box in 100 years. The old boy's name? It's Dusty. Okay. Yeah, we'll go and see if we can't find a sturgeon. I'm not going to go in there yet. We'll walk up and see if we can just get the sturgeon first. Because if I can, I can drop them both off. I'm very happy with that. I feel that, that the ocean spirits were particularly happy with us. Now, we're going to have to start thinking about the potluck soup. Our house is in such a beautiful area, don't you think? I actually do. I agree completely. Here, a daffodil. Thank you, this might come in handy. I'm sure it will if you want to impress any of your friends. Oh, hello. I don't think she's going to talk with me, no. She's in a world of her own, just enjoying the lake. Hey, have any interesting farm stories to tell me? Well, yeah, actually, my farm's pretty interesting because it's full of monsters. Guess not. Oh, how rude. Maru, why are you so mean? I mean, Abigail didn't even talk to me, but at least she didn't insult me. I think Team Abigail just fired a broadside and hit Team Maru square in the hull. Team Maru is taking on water right now. Never mind. Getting gold quality carp is pleasing me. It is reducing my feeling of having been insulted. Bullhead. We've got quite a lot of really nice fish here. Just need me a sturgeon, though. Again, hit's thick and fast, though. It's another lazy carp, isn't it? Yep. Bloody lazy carp. Oh, well. If I get a lot of you, you're very easy to catch. And very easy to catch at very high levels, so that's fine. I see you over there. Damn it. Damn it, 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 and damn it again. Sure, I'll eat this, because I don't want to go to the, I don't want to run up to the bathhouse when this is here. Nope, that's a little bit too close. There we go. I'll eat another one of the fish if I have to. One of the lazy carps, perhaps. Okay, you're not a lazy carp. You're a little bit too energetic, but you're not moving very fast. You might be a sturgeon. No, you're a chub. Well, chub. Nom. Sorry, but that is the fate of not sturgeons. It isn't fair. I know. I know. Need the green algae as well, because I do need the energy. That's about right. Okay. Come on, sturgeon. Lazy carp. Yes, lazy carp. That's fine. If I get a gold star carp, I'm fine with that. Oh no, it's a chub. Wasn't even a gold star. It's just a silver. Oop. If this is either going to be a chub or a carp, I suspect a carp. I feel this game is not doing you any favors, carp. I think it's kind of it's giving you a bad name as this lazy, can't be bothered fish. Ooh, that one's moving around. Might be a chub, this one. Still kind of lethargic like the carp, but not... But a little bit more energetic in small bursts, whereas the carp is just a smooth, smooth swimming fish. Never really jumps around too much. Another carp. Okay, I'm starting to get exhausted again. On the plus side, I got that, which, frankly, I don't care about. I'll go in there. Sure, I'll eat this carp. I'm not going to abandon this fishing spot. That would be madness. And also, I'm not going to eat my cave food either, because that would be madness. I need that for the cave, because it heals more and gives me more energy. There we go. Also, it's much easier for me to get in large numbers in a stack, since I directly make it. Alright, well, I'm not sure I'm going to get a sturgeon. I'm not sure if it's a night fish, if it's a day fish. Either way, it'll be useful to find out here. But I'm thinking I might need to move from this spot, because I'm fishing in the same spot. I'm getting a lot of fish, yes. But I'm fishing in exactly the same distance from the shore, which implies that I'm going to get exactly the same thing back constantly. So as good as this is for money, I am making bank right now. It's not exactly the best thing for me to be doing if I'm aiming to catch a specific fish. Ooh, this one's a little bit more lively. Or it was. What have we got? We've got a bullhead. Actually, cancel, cancel. I need to eat something. You can go. Nom. The carp have actually got a decent bit of energy in them. Then I'll eat this chub as well. We'll go until 10 PM, then I need to head back to the farm because I want to plant the plants that I've got. And as much as I've said I'm going to move from this spot, I'm really not. I may as well stick here. Oh, need to renew. Oh, damn! It was the bouncing at the top. That was a difficult chance to get because it was so close to the top that my bobber bounced. That was a bit of a shame there. I needed the fish to get a lot closer to the treasure chest so I didn't have to spend so much time in transit to the treasure chest whilst the capture time was going down. Damn it. Can't believe these bubbles are still here. This genuinely, I mean, the thing going through my mind is that, yeah, I really should move somewhere else. I should go and fish elsewhere if I want to catch a sturgeon. But at the same time, this is making me a lot of money right now. All of these fish, I wouldn't be surprised if I get like over 1,000 gold from today just purely in fish. In fact, I'd probably get a lot more than 1,000 gold. Oh, thank goodness. I'm glad that's gone, frankly, because now I don't feel so bad leaving. How much did I get? 2 red mullets, a tuna, a bullhead, 2 carp, a silver carp, 2 silver bullhead, and a silver chub. Not bad at all. I know why I didn't catch sturgeon, though. It just occurred to me. I didn't give the spirit of the mountain lake any sacrifices. What a noob mistake. Noob mistake. I know better than this. I apologize, everyone, for my derp. Right, let's go back. We'll drop a whole load of this off in the produce bin. Probably get assaulted by slimes as well, because, you know, this is my farm. You can go... the tuna's staying with me, though. Bullheads. Both of you. The coral. The earth crystal can stay. The clam can go. I've already dealt with these, so I'm just gonna send them away. Right, there we are. That is, I've already, used them. But I know the earth crystals will come in handy. I need that. I would like to get my 2 little flowers down here. Oh, sure, why not? Why not actually, fertilize them as well. I'm going to need my watering can, of course. go. They're under the protection of my scarecrow. So, and then, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 there. So, I'll plant these down. I am sorry for the mess of my farm at the moment. It will get better, I hope. But there we are. I think we're good for the rest of the day. Any sap at all? No, unfortunately. It'll take a little while before we get that. I do need to top up my watering can, though. And then we will drop off the clay. I will place the tuna over here. And we're good for the night. Oh, pickles. In that case, these can go in the produce bin as well. We're actually going to make a fair old bit of money with this. I'm very hopeful for a good return. We might even have enough to make ourselves a... I'm going to put both of these down here. We might even end up with enough from that to get our axe upgraded. Let's be hopeful. 240 from the pickles, 130 from foraging, 1,154 from fishing, and 130 from mining. So in total, 1,654. Very, very nice indeed. Super happy with that return. Super happy. Cock-a-doodle-doo to you as well. There we are. We have enough to get our axe upgraded. I am looking forward to that. So, hopefully you enjoyed this episode. I know it was very fishing heavy. Do let me know if you'd rather me cut out some of that. But in the next episode, we're going to be going and getting our axe upgraded, which means that for 2 days, we're not going to be able to cut down any trees. It's a bit of a pain, but at the end of it, we'll be able to cut down more trees, which, you know, it balances out in the long run. But thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Remember to leave a like if you liked and sub if you haven't. But until next time, take care of yourselves.